very, very clear, then how long she will be allowed to work. Once the wife starts the job, she is out of the house, she is working. Now, after down the 2 years down the line, 1 year down the line, all of a sudden, the husband, spouse, he comes and try to stop him. It is very difficult for her to quit the job. So before she starts the job, it should be very, very clear and agreed upon by both the spouse that how long she will work. Either within when they get the first child, or when they establish the house, after that she will quit the job. All these things should be very, very clear. The another thing, there is no matter of discussion. There is no point of discussion, because whatever the wife earned, that should be very clear. The boys, the brothers, they should learn that whatever wife earns, that belongs to her. Every penny belongs to her, and she is not obliged to spend a single penny to make your house. Not for your children, not for your clothes, not for even one, her own clothes, her own living, her own expenses. That is your duty to provide her. Now again, discuss this matter, that either she will be ready to help you or not. If she is ready to help you, then how much, what portion from the earning she will give you, and she will help you with that portion. That should be very, very clear also. After that, the couple, they should decide and they should discuss through the channel or after the marriage that when they will have the first child. Definitely living within the hudud of Sharia, that when they will have the first child. Sometimes it happens that after the marriage, few days of the marriage, the wife is pregnant, then the difficult change of life occurs. The wife cannot represent herself how she used to before, 2 weeks before, 3 weeks before. And because the boy is newly married, and in our culture, before marriage, he didn't have no experience about opposite sex, about the marital life, so he gets frustrated. He expected a lot. He wanted to enjoy a lot. But all of a sudden, there is a change in life. So though he doesn't say anything, but there's a frustration, some of the cases. And some of the cases, alhamdulillah, when they listen the news, the first child, the whole family get happy. It's a different thing. But still, the couple, they should discuss the matter that when they will have, after how long of the marriage, they will have the first child. And once again, today's life is advanced. No more like before, that you living in one city and in one place, not moving whole life. The father was living in the same house, the child got married in the same house, wife came in the same house, and there is the very famous proverb that I came as a wife in this house, and my body, the dead body, will come out from this house. But those days gone now. Every month we're moving from this city, that country, that country, because of the job, because of the profession, because of the situation. So before the couple get married, they should clear this matter very, very nicely, that which city they're going to live in. What happens, once again, the same place, either within USA or the boy, one of the spouse, they're living here and they get married in some other country. Sometimes, normally, most of the cases, the boy think, the family of the boy, they think that we will bring the girl in our house, she will live with us. But sometimes the parents of the girl, they also think, no, that we are in the better position, we are in the better city, economically, financially, and politically, we are in a better place. So the boy should come here and he should live with us. So that matter also should be very, very clear, that after the marriage, after the wedding is over, then which city both of them will live. Then another matter also should be very, very clear. Either they will live in the parents' house, or the boy will arrange a separate apartment or house or whatever it is. That should be very clear also. Today's time and Sharia also, that also Sharia doesn't like force the couple to live with the parents. Yeah, the Sharia gives some instruction, some advice that the couple, the newly married, the boy and the girl, and the children, they should have respect, they should take care of the parents. That is completely different aspect, different topic. But here, they are allowed to live their own. So when Sharia gives us the permission, so we should discuss this matter and we should make it clear that where they will live after the marriage, which either separate house or they will live with the parents. Once this is clear, the both of them will be clear, no, yes, after the marriage, I have to live. Otherwise, what happens? Yes, we're getting married. Maybe he's expecting, maybe this month, maybe next month, maybe third month. Then slowly, that frustration, that stress bust up and they start arguing, they start fighting. We married so long, still you couldn't arrange a house, this sort of blah, blah, blah. So before that comes, then the situation comes, they should make it clear that which house they're going to live in. Then once the couple is married, now the war, the fight starts, that who got the leadership role and who is in charge in relationship, who will control the house. And today's time that our sisters, the women, they're not ready to so easily accept the leadership role of a man because of the situation, because of the slogan, because of the propaganda that equality, freedom of women, because of the lack of proper Islamic education. There's two different things, my respected brothers and sisters. Equality, equal. Women, men and women are equals in right, but not equal in duties and responsibilities in physical appearance. They're different thing. Men cannot be a mother. Mother cannot be a father. There's different responsibilities. But yes, they are equal in right. So if we look at the Islamic perspective, then we will find, yes, man has the leadership role in the family after the marriage. But once again, it should be borne in mind. The Sayyidul Qawmi Khadimuhum. The leader of the community is a servant of the community. He will serve the community in the same way. If the man got the leadership role in the family, then he should be loving, he should be caring, he should be nourishing, he should be cherishing, and he should be forgiving. And after all,